Great Smokies. Nothing in my life had prepared me for the wonder of those mountains. Smoke blue and serene folded one behind the other. I counted 11 ranges rising up toward the vault of the sky. I didn't realize it then, but from the very first moment I saw them, the mountains were a source of peace and strength to me, always there to quiet my mind and satisfy my heart. Spoke at our church with such love of her Highlanders. I knew before the hymn was done that I would volunteer for Miss Alice Henderson's mission, and that my parents would be against it. But through all their pleas and arguments, I never wavered. Only the look of love in my mother's eyes as I was about to leave made my heart skip a beat, and the way my father held my hand while we waited for the train.
All right, boy, let's have the miracle. Now, wait a minute. Anyone can pull it once it's been pulled.
You
go to it, Kay. Give it all you got. Put your
head in it.
That's not fair.
I say we let the boy try it.
That's what I say. Give the boy a chance.
Go ahead, son.
It's a miracle, ordained by heaven. This boy is our king.
Well, by Jove.
What's the lad's name?
Arthur.
Hail, King Arthur!
Hail, King Arthur! Long live the king!
I can't believe it!
Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart, and as punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, The beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose which would bloom until his 21st year. If he could learn to love another and earn her love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
700 years into the future, mankind will leave our planet, leaving Earth's cleanup in the hands of one incredible machine. His name is Wally.
After all these years,
he's developed one little glitch.
What?
A personality. He's extremely curious.
And just a little bit lonely. But all that is about to change. Wow.
Robot.
10 seconds to self-destruct. You are now free to move around the cabin.
Just a trail? You look gorgeous.
Aren't you?
We're more like treasure protectors.
To this day, the clues they left are all around us.
On the dollar bill is an encryption.
Try to tell me something.
And for Benjamin Franklin Gates,
every generation in our family has searched for the treasure.
They'll lead to an adventure 2,000 years in the making.
You think there is a treasure map on the back of the
Declaration of Independence?
Where's your proof?
We don't have it.
Did Bigfoot take it?
I'm gonna steal it.
What?
I'm gonna steal the Declaration of Independence.
Ben?
From producer Jerry Bruckheimer and director John Turteltaub.
What do you see?
There's more to the riddle.
The secrets.
Okay, who wants to go down the creepy tunnel first?
Will all be revealed.
Tell me what the next clue is.
Nicolas Cage. National Treasure.
Do you trust me?